1942. The relentless Japanese war machine rolls down through Southeast Asia like a deadly virus. Australia is open to invasion. The Americans, their fleet at the bottom of Pearl Harbor and their eyes turned toward the Philippines, are in no position to help. 10,000 Japanese make their way up the narrow trail from Kokoda toward us. We are alone. Direction of our new colonel, we are digging in at the village of Isaraba on the Kokoda track. Weakened by lack of food, sleep and shelter, many of us are exhausted to the point of collapse. We have been here 2 weeks now. Waiting. We're told the Australian Army will be here to relieve us soon. They are called the AIF. We're called Chocos. Volunteers sent to New Guinea to unload ships and dig roads. Chocolate soldiers. The AIF assumes we will melt in the heat of battle. They are probably right. Untrained and ill-equipped, riddled with dysentery and malaria, we're the only men available to make a stand against the Japanese. They outnumber us 10 to 1 and will attack any day now. We are lambs to the slaughter.
We won. We found on its own. It's this. Good on you, mate.
39. Who 97 years ago stormed the shores of Anzac Cove, or who 70 years ago in July fell back on Isharaba in the face of a Japanese onslaught. The men of the 39th Battalion, a militia unit drawn from Australia, pushed forward across the Kokoda Track to try and buy time for those who were defending Port Moresby. Here they were joined by men of the 21st Brigade, the 2nd 14th and the 2nd 16th. And here for 4 days they held the Japanese. The CO of their unit, Ralph Honnard, described this area as the Australian Thermopylae. Like the Spartans, thousands of years before them, they were designed to hold the enemy, to show sacrifice, to show endurance, above all, to show courage and mateship. And that they did. Like those young men who had stormed the shores at Anzac Cove, they too answered the nation's call. They too held the nation and its people to the fore. They gave their lives so that we might live ours. They were aided and supported throughout by the men and women of Papua New Guinea. Here on battlefields where capture was a death sentence and wounding was something close, it was the Papua New Guineans and the Fuzzy Wuzzy Angels that stood shoulder to shoulder with Australians. I am honoured as the Chief of the Army to be here with veterans of the Kokoda Battles. I am honoured to be here with my fellow Australians who are making now what is almost a pilgrimage to their sacrifice. And I am honoured to be joined by the men and women of Papua New Guinea as we all remember those deeds of 70 years ago, lest we forget.
Lest we forget.